video, we will be discussing about infinitives, and then we are going to understand the type of infinitive, which is direct infinitive. So, before coming to the concept of infinitives, let us understand the non-finites. Now, non-finites are those verbs which do not contain a subject in them, and neither do they contain any kind of person or a thing. So, non-finites are further divided as infinitives. So, infinitives are type of non-finites, and those infinitives are further categorized into different types. So, out of that, we will be understanding a type of infinitive, which is bare infinitive. But before that, let us understand infinitives. Now we know that infinitives are a type of non-finites. And infinitives are basically the verbs. So they are the verbs which are preceded by two verbs. Which are preceded by 2. For example, I say 2 plus my work. This is the structure of infinitives. Structure of infinitive is 2 plus a verb. Example can be 2 sing, 2 dance, 2 read. So now sing, dance and read are my verbs, and before verb, when we put an infinitive 2 or when we put 2, that becomes an infinitive. So infinitive, the structure of infinitive is 2 plus my verb. Now below this infinitive, we are going to understand the type of infinitive, which is direct infinitive, or it is also referred to as a bare infinitive. Now, direct infinitive or bare infinitive are all those type of infinitives which do not contain two in them. So, the definition of direct or bare infinitive is that these are the infinitives which do not contain two within them. Which means that this two is not present over here. Two is present, but it is in a hidden form. So because there is no two, and 2 is considered to be an infinitive, therefore they are also referred to as bare infinitive. They are also referred to as bare infinitive. For example, I would like you or I would like your help. So when I say I would like your help, means I would like you to help me. Now 2 plus help is an infinitive, but your help, it is a bare infinitive because the infinitive over there is hidden. Or another example can be, I can hear you. When I say I can hear you, means I can hear to you. But to you does not make any sense, therefore the infinitive over here is again hidden. So I can hear you is again an example of bare infinitive or a direct infinitive. Now next we are going to understand various applications in which bare infinitive or direct infinitive can be used. So now let us understand different applications of bare infinitive or direct infinitive. The first application is that these infinitives can be used with need or dare. So first application is that need or dare. These verbs do not contain the infinitive to when they are used in a negative form with auxiliaries. Need and dare used in negative form. When they are used in negative form with or not with, we can say as auxiliaries. When they are used as auxiliaries, then we do not make use of to as an infinitive over here, provided they are in interrogative form as well. So either in interrogative form or in negative form, when we make use of need or dare, then they come under the category of direct infinitive. Example is, like suppose I say, I do not need to work hard. Now this is my negative sentence, but again my sentence here need is not in the form of auxiliary. This is just my negative sentence. Right? Just a negative sentence. Then another example can be, I need to work hard. Again, when I say I need to work hard, here need is again just a simple verb and not an auxiliary, and this is again my affirmative sentence. Right? Then I say, do I need to work hard? Again, need and to is coming over here. This is my interrogative sentence. But when I say you need not work hard, when I say you need not, here need is acting as my auxiliary. And when need is acting as an auxiliary, then this rule perfectly matches with my sentence. You need not work hard. This is my negative auxiliary. So you need not work hard is my negative auxiliary. And I said that with negative form as auxiliary, here the rule fixes. And then another, when I say, need you work hard? Need you work hard? This is again my interrogative auxiliary. Here again, need is acting as an auxiliary. So here I will say, this is my interrogative auxiliary. So, with my negative auxiliary, I can find a direct infinitive, and with interrogative auxiliary as well, I can see that here my infinitive is direct. I do not make use of to over here along with my verb. So, this is the first application of direct or bare auxiliary. Let us understand another application of direct infinitive, and that application is that there are some verbs in which direct infinitive is used, right? Those verbs, I can say that direct infinitives are used in verbs. And those verbs are let, bid, feel, help, watch, hear, listen. Sorry, not listen, see. So these are some of the verbs with which we can make use of direct infinitives, which means that along with these verbs, two is not used, but we can say that they are used only in active voice. So direct infinitives with these verbs are used only in active voice and not in the passive voice, except for let. Let is used as a direct infinitive for both active and passive voice. Clear? Let is used as a direct infinitive both in active and passive voice. For example, I say the teacher let him go out. Now let to him is not required, or the teacher to let him not required. The teacher let him go out. This is my active voice. And then if I have to change this into passive voice, I will say he was let go out by the teacher. And when I say he was let go out by the teacher, this becomes my passive voice. Now we can notice that both in active, let and let go, let him and let go, in both these voices, we do not see to as an infinitive over here. Therefore, both these are my example of direct or bare infinitive. Another example can be, can you hear me? Now, can you hear me? Hear to me is not required. So again, this is my direct infinitive. I can watch you. Again, when I say I can watch you, I cannot say watch to you. So hear, watch. Or another example can be, I can listen to you. Now when I say I can listen to you, this is not an example of a bare infinitive. Now see, hear and listen are almost the same with just a fine difference between them. So, can you hear me? I can say, I can hear you. Here if I say, I can hear to you, then my sentence goes wrong. So, I can hear you is correct, but I can listen you is wrong. For that, I have to say, I can listen to you. So, here we can see that listen is not a verb which can be used without an infinitive. So here listen is not an example of a direct infinitive, it is an example of an indirect infinitive. So here the second application we discussed is that there are some verbs which can go with direct infinitives. Now the third application of direct infinitive is that whenever we are using words like have better, would rather, would better, as soon as. So some of these are the examples in which direct infinitive can be used. Here all these main use of direct infinitive. And direct infinitive means that there is no use of to along with these words. So now let us understand this application through example. So the first example can be, I would rather read books than watch movies. Again, I cannot say I would rather to read books. Yeah, I would to rather read books. No, this is a sentence in which the infinitive to is not required. So therefore, this comes under the category of a bare infinitive. Bare means without. So this is an example of a sentence in which to infinitive is not used. Another can say that she had rather visited me than stay at home. She had rather visited me than to stay at home. Not required, than stayed at home. So these are some of the examples of bare infinitives where have rather, have better, would rather, these words are not used. These words are used without the usage of to. Then let me explain through another example. Like I can say, I would as soon leave this place as sit over here. Again, this means the same, that I would rather leave this place than sit over here. The meaning is same, only the words that are used over here is different. So this is another application of bare infinitives. Direct infinitives are also used with words such as than, except, but, or, and. So this is another application that it is used with words like these. So the example of this can be, she did nothing but cry. So when I say but cry, I cannot say but to cry. So but plus cry, again an example of a direct infinitive. Then another example can be, Rita had nothing to do except sleep all day. So except, I cannot say except to sleep all day. I will just say except sleep all day. So again, an example of my direct infinitive. So here, this was the fourth application of direct infinitive. The fifth application of direct infinitive is that it can be used with why not or why as direct infinitive. It can be used with why not or why as direct infinitive. So for that I can say, why not stay here? So when I say why not stay here, here I am making a suggestion. This is my suggestion that I am giving to someone. So whenever I am suggesting something, I will say why not. So for suggestion, we can make use of direct infinitive. Then another example can be, why ask the same question? So when I say why ask the same question, here I am using as a simple why without a negative question. So again, why ask the same question here? I am asking a question. So it can be used for a suggestion or for asking question. Both ways are correct. So in this video, we have studied about the infinitive, which is bare infinitive, also known as direct infinitive. This is a type of infinitive in which no infinitive is used, directly the verb is used. Then we've discussed various applications of direct infinitive, and for each application we've implemented different examples through our sentences in order to understand each application clearly and in a better manner.